Good morning, students. Welcome. I am science teacher Sana Pesyam from Eklari High School.
Chapter 2: Life Processes in Living Organisms. Various organ systems are continuously performing their functions in human body, along with the various systems like digestive, respiratory, circulatory, excretory, and control systems. Those are in need of continuous source of energy for this purpose. Carbohydrates, fats, and lipids are the main sources of energy, and it is harvested by the mitochondria present in each cell. It is not like that of only foodstuff is sufficient for energy production, but oxygen is also necessary. Human and animals consume the fruits and vegetables. Plants are autotrophic. They prepare their own food. They utilize some of the food for themselves, where remaining is stored in various parts like fruits, leaves, stems, roots, etc. Student, we obtain the carbohydrates from milk, fruits, jaggery, cane sugar, vegetables, potatoes, sweet potatoes, cane sugar, sweet cereals like wheat, maize, etc. Here some pictures of potatoes, sweet potatoes, then wheat and maize, then ragi, and there is also jowar and rice. We get 4 kilocalorie energy from that. Students, you know many players are seen consuming some foodstuffs during their breaks of the game. They got energy from those foodstuffs. Our next topic is living organisms and energy production. Respiration. In living organisms, respiration occurs at 2 levels, as body and cellular level. Oxygen and carbon dioxide are exchanged between body and surrounding in case of respiration. In case of respiration at cellular level, foodstuffs are oxidized either with or without the help of oxygen. Students, you know carbohydrates of the food that we consume every day are mainly utilized for production of energy required for daily need. This energy is obtained in the form of ATP. For this purpose, glucose, a type of carbohydrates, is oxidized step by step in the cell. This is called cellular respiration. ATP means, you know, adenosine triphosphate. There are two methods, aerobic respiration. In this, oxygen is involved, and anaerobic respiration. In this method, oxygen is not involved. In aerobic respiration, glucose is oxidized in three types. First is glycolysis, that is, in Marathi, it is called as glucose vighatan. Second is TCA cycle, tricarboxylic acid cycle. And third, electron transfer chain reaction.